You are about to start the audiobook of the book review of Existentialism and Humanism, a famous work by Jean-Paul Sartre. During this reading, you will first discover a brief context of the work and its author. Then, a summary of the work will be presented, followed by an analysis of the characters and the key points of the novel. Once these different points have been addressed, all that remains is to conclude this listening session with a few questions that may further fuel your reflection. The author. Jean-Paul Sartre was a French writer and philosopher. He was born in Paris in 1905 and died in 1980. Celebrated and at the same time rejected for his existentialist thinking, he is the author of several essays, such as Being and Nothingness, 1943, and Existentialism and Humanism, 1946. He also wrote several literary texts in which his philosophy and his definition of literature have a strong presence, including Nausea, a novel published in 1938, The Flies, a play which first came out in 1943, and No Exit, published in 1944. In 1964, he turned down the Nobel Prize in Literature and published The Words, an autobiographical story about his youth. Also known as the partner of Simone de Beauvoir, French writer, 1908-1986, Sartre made a strong impression on his audience both with his writings and with his far-left political views. The work. Existentialism and Humanism, 1946, first published in English in 1948, is the retranscription, with some minor edits by Sartre, of a lecture he gave in 1945 at the Club Maintenant, which was set up after the liberation of France. The lecture was extremely successful, which speaks volumes about Sartre's fame, although this fame was often accompanied by a poor comprehension of the philosopher himself. This is one of the reasons Sartre decided to make this speech. In it, Sartre explains what his philosophy truly consists of, responds to criticisms which had been leveled against him, presents man in the full extent of his freedom and responsibilities, and proves that, far from being pessimistic, existentialism advocates action and commitment. Summary. Existence precedes essence. Sartre lays out the main criticisms made of existentialism. Communists see it as a bourgeois philosophy of unrealistic actions. Catholics see it as a pessimistic philosophy which denies the importance of human efforts while also eliminating divine values. Everyone accuses existentialism of disregarding human solidarity through a subjectivity which isolates the individual. Generally speaking, people find existentialism sad and ugly, even if the wisdom of the people, page 24, seems just as depressing to Sartre. According to atheistic existentialism, existence precedes essence. Before Sartre, philosophers had the idea that man is determined by human nature, like a manufactured object whose essence precedes its existence, its use, the production method, and everything else which defines it comes before and determines its manufacture. But for Sartre, man surges up in the world and defines himself afterwards. Page 28. There is therefore no human nature, and man becomes what he makes of himself, or even what he wants himself to be. Man is viewed as a project. He is responsible for himself, and existentialism wants to make him aware of this. This philosophy comes from a double subjectivity, both individual and personal. By choosing and acting individually with the intention of becoming what we want to be, we make of ourselves a project which is valuable for everyone, because what we consider the right choice for oneself reflects the image of man as we think he should be. Being aware of such responsibility for oneself and others, when man has to make a choice without knowing which values to hold on to, can cause anguish. The demand of choice. Faced with the inexistence of God, man is left in a state of abandonment, an existentialist notion which goes hand in hand with anguish, and it is his task to draw his own conclusions. What is good is no longer written anywhere nor theoretically determinable. The choice is therefore given to man himself, who is condemned to be free. Page 34. He is entirely responsible for his passions as well as his interpretation of the world. Sartre gives the example of a student who is torn between two choices, staying by his mother's side or abandoning her to her despair and joining the resistance in order to avenge his brother and help his country. When faced with such an impossible decision, man must choose between two types of morality. Immediate, individual help. Action on a larger scale, which is more ambiguous, who can predict if he will play an important role or an insignificant one? No fixed doctrine can resolve this dilemma. Choosing according to what feels right is also illusionary, since deciding that, in the end, you value your mother more than your country can only be proved by actually staying with her, and not merely by envisaging it. Similarly, in choosing someone to advise us, we have already decided which answer we want to hear. In order to act, man must take into account the probabilities which directly concern his action and make it possible. Becoming a Marxist would imply counting on a well-unified party and on comrades who will fight.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.